Hello.
Hello.
I'm awfully glad you kept our date, Soldier.
Didn't you expect me to?
No.
Didn't I swear it on my love for you?
That's why I didn't expect you.
You're not going to start ribbing me again, are you?
No. Not after you've flown over the ocean just to see me. Weren't you afraid?
Of you or the ocean?
Of both of us.
I was only hoping to find you here. I saw you dancing.
I saw you too. You were sitting with the king.
Yeah, he tried his best to get me to tell him which priorat was mine, but I didn't.
Why not?
Well, he seemed to be a pretty gay old duck, that king of yours.
Oh, yes?
I was afraid he might try to steal you away from me.
Yes, he probably would. But he's really an awfully nice king.
Well, I don't know much about kings or queens, but I do want to know more about you.
For instance?
Well, first of all, I'd like to know what your name is.
Oh, what's in a name?
Ah, there you go. Kidding again. Can't you take me seriously?
I didn't mean to offend you.
Yes, you did. You've been trying to hurt me ever since we met. And I don't like it.
You don't like me?
Yes, I do. I love you. That's the trouble. I love you too much. You don't deserve it.
Why not?
Because you're mean. You're sarcastic. And I can't talk to you except when I'm alone.
Do you really talk to me when you're alone?
Yes, I do. Often.
What do you say?
I tell you that I love you more than anything else in the world. And when you try to laugh at me, I take you in my arms and hold you there. And sometimes I serenade you again, as I did at Vassar. And in my mind, I see you at the window, listening and smiling.
And in my mind, I often hear you. Oh, Dick, it's wrong. I'm sorry, Dick, you kept our date. It would have been much better if you'd just gone on imagining.
Because you don't love me?
No, because I do.
Well, then...
Dick, tell me again that you love me.
In the still of the night, while I'm drifting and dreaming, in the still of the night, my thoughts all stray to you. By the moon's mellow light, while the world is in slumber, oh, the times without number, darling, when I say to you,
they're ringing now.
Perhaps for us.
Your Highness. Your Highness must forgive this intrusion. Your father, the King, has just now proclaimed your betrothal to my son. And His Majesty desires that you come at once and with Prince Paul appear before your people. Whereof, if you escort our Highness, I will attend my son. His Majesty also requested that I look for you, sir, and discover whether or not you had found the young lady you were looking for.